right turnvale going into the site. We've looked at West Post on the opposite side. We've looked at the adjacent access into Nocturne Ridge. We don't feel that there's sufficient grounds there for us to sustain an objection or appeal against this application on highway safety grounds.
Thank you, Keith Kelly, for the subject committee.
Thanks, Chair. I did go to the site visit, and it was only an outline planning permission, and we need to look at obviously the access points in which that's what we're doing. And while we were there, at the site visit, we had made two near misses, very near hit and run of a cat, and very near fatal death of the cat. I was so alarmed at the, how extremely dangerous this bend is. Traffic calming measures that are in place at the moment are practically zero, as far as I can see. While I was there, I was actually approached by a member of the public in relation to the Nocturne Ridge entrance, and he just said to me, "Can you please, please look as if you can get better signage signs before traffic calming measures on this bend?" So not only was I approached by a member of the public, I also see two near misses and a near fatal death of a cat. So unless it has, this application has real good, solid traffic calming measures in place, then I'm going to be refusing this application.
Keith, would you like to come back and cover the
question?
Thank you for you, Chair. Yeah, when we were on site, obviously, I visited the site on a number of occasions, and the road safety managers visited the site on a number of occasions. I've never noted any vehicles parking on that bend, nor as the road safety manager. I've never noticed any vehicles parking that close to the end of West Coast. However, that being said, if that was an issue in terms of if I felt that was an issue in terms of parking on that bend, and it was something that's happened on a too frequent basis, in the mouth of West Coast, I would ask for waiting restrictions as part of this application. I don't feel that this application is going to add anything to the parking on that bend if it is parking that's taking place, because there's plenty of parking provision within the application site as shown on the drawing that's submitted. So I don't see that this application is going to create the problems that we saw with the parking by the minibus on the day that we visited. So on those grounds, again, as I say, I came to the conclusion that there's no sustainable grounds to object.
Steve?
Okay. Clearly, we've heard the evidence of the highways engineer, and I think we're long enough in the tooth on this committee to know that when there's an existing traffic issue, and when an application is not a major application in terms of numbers, the phrase comes out, well, what big difference will three extra developments make in terms of vehicles as we stand? In some ways, you have to say, but I think apart from anything else that happens with this plan application, we have to have a serious, as engineers, have a serious look at that. We've seen on the day that we didn't tell the bus driver to park where he parked. He naturally thought that was okay to park there, and we've seen two or three incidents on the day of the visit. So, highways issues are an issue. Whether we can get sustainable plan refusal and highways issues, I doubt it, given already the evidence that's been presented in terms of that. So which brings me back to the actual nature of the development. I sort of talked about it before about another application about housing strategy you need for more houses and so on and so forth. We are in a position now at the moment that we are working with the rules that we have. And on the last application, quite likely, we applied those rules with some vigour, and that an application was refused. And I know each application is on its merits. However, my concern is that these areas develop their nature because we so desired, our forefathers desired these areas to be of such a nature. This area is a very pleasant part of the ward I happen to represent, but may well be replicated in each one of the planning committee members' areas where they live. And they develop for a reason, because our forefathers and our planning maintain this openness, the big back gardens, and everything that, that goes with that. To make comparison, I think the applicant did, to sort of bear Basson's weight and so on and so forth. Well, Basson's weight was designed and built for that particular area. So my view is, in terms of that sort of ridge guidelines, which still have some reality and reference, the area is both sides of Bell Road, right down to NOCTORUM Avenue, and then sandwiched in between the more dense housing estates at the top, and then further down you come onto the NOCTORUM estate. But my view is that this area has a distinct character, a distinct geography, and a distinct area to be defended. So while the rules of engagement that we're involved in allow us to try and defend these areas, my view is, whether it be as a ward councillor or some other members of the planning committee, is to use what weapons are at your disposal. And my weapons of disposal are, you fair the mat, not exactly to the wording of the previous refusal, but similar. And it will develop a backland development. There's no doubt about that. But that back garden will be of a different nature of any other garden in those geographical terms that I design. And we can't talk about future applications or present being set, but it will happen. I hear, or I've been told that the white paper is talking about encouraging backland developments or garden plots. That's not with us yet. That is only a white paper, not the rules. Our new housing strategy will be going out to consultation, and that might be a way in the future of protecting other more cherished areas such as Greenbelt and so on. But at the moment, we have the ability as a committee to actually put fairly good reasons for refusal down. And I have those, they're not dissimilar to the previous refusal, they're long-winded as well, just like the previous refusal. However, I will move them, but I will allow them to discussion, but I will be moving reasons for refusal.
Yeah, thanks, Chair. I mean, I also attended the site visit, so my kind of comments would be I am concerned about the road safety issue. I don't think what anybody else has actually highlighted so far since Matthew spoke is the fact that the access to the site is moving closer to the bend. I think we all saw the site visit. It's not an ideal road network in terms of road safety. And you know, I'm struck by the fact that the residents are saying there's been a dozen collisions in the last whatever years, and the actual road safety record is 3 in the last 10. So I think that highlights one important aspect to me is the importance of actually reporting to the police when collisions actually do occur. I get very frustrated when I hear about a collision in my ward and the police have not been notified, and then it doesn't appear on the statistics. You know, I think that's something we could all learn from. But I really am concerned about approving anything which could subsequently, if I read in 5 years' time, if this gets developed, that somebody's turning right into that enlarged development. Somebody's coming around the corner and going too fast, as people do, smashing into the back of them, and somebody ends up dead. I am concerned about that. I think the issue about the garden grabbing, I've sat here at plenty of committees and seen people approve back garden developments, and I totally sympathise with what the ward councillor and others might say about that, and I'm queasy about it myself, but in planning terms, whether we get away with it, I do wonder. But in terms of the road safety, I am concerned. I would ask one question. Do we have any information about those three incidents? Can we say anything about the character of those collisions that would help inform our judgment about the issue?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I need to be cautious because obviously these are confidential details that we're provided with. But the road safety officer has provided me with some details. One was a young female driver at 2:40 a.m. on a Sunday morning, collided with a stationary vehicle and failed to stop. Another was an elderly driver who stopped behind a parked vehicle. We're not exactly certain of the location, but it was potentially somewhere on the bend or near to the bend.
proposed would introduce a form of backland development that would appear incongruous when set against the prevailing pattern of frontage development with private interlocking rear gardens. A large part of the site would be required for access, term facilities and parking areas for the two new dwellings at the rear of the site. And such physical alterations and hard surfacing would erode the pleasant green character of the existing gardens, with the resulting level of activity from associated vehicle movements being at odds with the quiet nature of surrounding gardens. Dwellings sited at the rear of the application site as proposed would introduce a pattern of development that would lead to detrimental damage in the character of the area, and furthermore, by introducing additional domestic activity in this backland site, the existing standards of residential amenity in the immediate vicinity of properties surrounding the site would be seriously diminished. Therefore, it is considered that the development does not comply with policies HS4 and HS10 of the Wirral Unity Development Plan, Supplementary Planning Guidance, Note 10, or the principles of the National Planning Policy Framework. And I would so move, Chair, as that is a reason for confusion.
Chair,
Councillor.
Could I second that? Like, just make a comment on that, reader. I mean, my concern with that is that. Matthew, help me with the form of words.
I
then something can appeal, it needs to be backed up with evidence. And the evidence, unfortunately, I hear what Councillor Davis has said and what some of the residents have said, but it isn't backed up with statistics or evidence that we would have to rely on at an appeal. So you've heard what the engineer has had to say, and unfortunately, there isn't the evidence to back it up. However, if it's something that you want to pursue, unfortunately, I am struggling to come up with a form of words at the moment to back that up.
Just to be clear, these would be additional words on top of what Steve has.
I would recommend that it would be a separate form of a separate reason for refusal. I can't predict how the appeal would go, but what Councillor Foulkes has put forward seems to be something that we would stand a good chance of defending as we do. But if you wanted to introduce a highways reason for refusal, then I would suggest that that is done as a second reason for refusal and not included in the first.
Thank you.
permission is sought for the erection of two assisted living units along with hard and soft landscaping. The proposal is a revised scheme following the grant of planning permission in 2016. The number of units does not alter. Two proposed with this application, together with two units proposed at item 12. There would therefore be four units as previously approved. The previously approved scheme allowed for two detached units. This scheme seeks consent for two units joined together in one L-shaped building. Some of the materials have also changed, resulting in a form of development that is now considered to be more complementary to the adjacent listed Arrowe Hall. The modest changes in layout, design and materials are considered to be acceptable and would not harm the open character of the greenbelt or the setting of a greater listed building. There have been no objections to this proposal or item 12, and there is no petition in connection to either application.
Can I have the subject? Nothing's changed, but if it's something that you feel would be appropriate to do, what can I?